The night the group split up, Vicious was pulled off a plane at Kennedy Airport, the victim of a drug overdose. Since then, he's lived at the Chelsea Hotel, performing infrequently. Yesterday, police found him there, in room 100, and on the bathroom floor, they found the 20-year-old American girl he'd lived with for 2 years. Sid Vicious reportedly admitted he'd stabbed Nancy Laura Spungen to death. And no one who knew him could believe it.
But he really loved this person. I mean, you know, he'd been quoted in papers all around the world as stating it. He felt that Nancy was the most... was the woman of the world. He felt that women should be like Nancy. And he loved her more than he loved his music.
Sid Vicious, whose real name is John Simon Ritchie, was arraigned today on charges of murder. He said he felt sick. His manager was told bailing him out pending trial would be extremely difficult. He's an alien, he's not employed, and he's given to violent outbursts of temper. But his manager said, and I quote, underneath that tough exterior, there was a real nice guy.
Sid Vicious will not have to stand trial for the murder of a girlfriend at the Chelsea Hotel. Sid is no longer vicious, he's dead. His nude body found in a Greenwich Village apartment, spoon and syringe nearby. The heroin overdose may have been accidental. Sid Vicious, a British punk rocker, became famous by being well known. Certainly not for his music. Perhaps for his public obscenities, antisocial statements, and vulgarities. Bob Lape has more.
Well, just one more in hundreds of overdose deaths in New York City every year. This one was the ultimate for a punk rocker whose life was a discordant jangle that gave savage substance to his stage name, Sid Vicious. John Simon Ritchie, dead of a heroin overdose at a girlfriend's home here on Bank Street.
Detective Hausman, he arrived here at 6 p.m. last night.
The party followed.
Right.
The heroin was injected about...
midnight.
Midnight. He had an overdose reaction at that point.
Right.
And then...
He came out of it, and then he went back. Then a little while later, he went back to bed, and then he died in his sleep.
The ex-Sex Pistol was described as happy about prospects for a bright future when he came here to 63 Bank last night and girlfriend Michelle Robinson and his mother and partied a bit after having been released from Rikers Island.